Hello everyone, I am Hosanna David. I just want to share with us some truth in God's word. If you look at our society today, there are so many Christians who struggle with their Christian life. And I feel it is time I should give some truths so that those who have some struggles can actually find a way to come out of their struggles. We know that the society we live in today is becoming more and more ungodly, and the race of Christianity is becoming more and more cumbersome, very, very tiring this time around. Because iniquity, the Bible says, because iniquity shall abound, the love of many shall wax cold. Now, what I want to talk about today is about what we expose ourselves to. I mean, what we listen to. The Bible says in Luke chapter 8, verse 18, that be careful how you hear. What we listen to has a lot of effect on our Christian life and our relationship with God. A lot of people feel that they can just buy any music, play any music, and listen to any musician, and listen to any kind of joke, and don't even mind whether it has any effect on us. Jesus said, I want to read Matthew chapter 12, verse 34. Jesus said, O generation of vipers, how can ye, being evil, speak good things? For out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaketh. A good man out of the good treasures of the heart bringeth forth good things, and an evil man out of the evil treasure bringeth forth evil things. So let me just add verse 36. But I say unto you that every idle word that men shall speak, they shall give account thereof in the day of judgment. For by thy words thou shalt be justified, and by thy words thou shalt be condemned. That is verse 37. Jesus knows the power of the mind, that whatsoever thing we do originates out of our mind. There is nothing that we do that does not come out of our mind. Everything originates from the heart. That is why when God judges offense, when he judges the sinner, he goes to the root. And while he was even dealing with sin, he didn't just say, repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand. He also taught us how we can avoid sin. Sin can be avoided. Jesus said, when he was addressing the issue of adultery in Matthew chapter 5, verse 27, 25, 26, Matthew chapter 5, verse 27, I think, yes. He said, you have heard by them of old, thou shalt not commit adultery. But I say unto you, that whosoever looketh at a woman so as to have passion for her in his heart, has already committed adultery with her in his heart. So what is Jesus saying here? He means, what he's saying is that, yes, this is what the Lord says, but I tell you that adultery does not begin the moment you take a woman or to a man that you know married to the bed. It begins right in your heart. And while he was addressing the issue of murder, he talked about anger, being angry with your brother without a cause. And he said, the Bible says that we should be angry, but we should not sin. That means that anger actually leads to greater sins. Just being angry is not a sin. Anger is not a sin, but by the time you grow angry and the anger leads you into sin. I have to explain, because I know some people will ask me if I actually mean anger is not a sin. We are human beings. We are emotional beings. If we see something that is offensive, we don't have control over these reactions. The body actually reacts. It is a chemical thing, it's a psychological thing. Like, you see something that is amusing, you laugh. You see something that can make you sad, immediately your hormones are stimulated, your heart your brain interprets, the sight interprets whatsoever thing you hear, whatsoever stimuli you receive into your body, you respond to it. But the Bible is, what the Bible is saying is that if you see something that makes you angry, don't dwell on the anger. What you need to do is you fight it, forgive, and move on with your life. Don't nurse it. That is what the Bible says. We should not allow the sun to go down on our anger. That means so long as we are humans, we can be sad, we can be happy, we can be sorrowful, we can be joyful. But when it is a bad emotion, we should not dwell on it. So even when Cain, before Cain killed Abel, I'm talking about a human heart and how Jesus actually attacked sin from the root. Before Cain killed Abel, the Bible says that God himself warned Cain. He told Cain, why are you angry? If you have done well, wouldn't I have received your sacrifices? But you have not done well. Now sin lieth at your door. His desire is to have you, but you must master it. God saw that Cain was angry and that the anger could lead to something worse. So God decided to quickly go to Cain and warn him, advise him to stay away from anger. But Cain never paid attention. He went on to do what his anger led him to. You can read the Bible, Genesis chapter 4. What I just said now is in, if you start reading from verse 6, you will see the conversation of God with Cain right there. So let's come back to today's topic. Out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaketh. The Bible says, be careful how you hear. What do you expose yourself to? Now, talking about music, a lot of people don't know the power of music. God created music, and Lucifer, we don't have Lucifer today. What is existing today is Satan, the devil, the ancient serpent. He has lost that position. He's no longer Lucifer. That is why I said we don't have Lucifer today. He was created as a worshiper. The Bible says that he was created in the book of Ezekiel. He was created with precious stones. He was so beautiful. But when pride came over him, he lost his place. He was in charge of the worship in heaven. Yeah, I would liken him to a position of choir master, and there were musical instruments all over him. So because of his position while he was in heaven, he knows the power of music. And Satan today, through the help of musicians, is promoting evil, mesmerizing the minds of people. There is real mind control in music. I listened to the confession of John Todd, who was an Illuminati, a witchcraft a priest, and also a musician. He made confession. In fact, one of the things he said is that whenever a satanic agent, some of these stars you see, people like Rihanna, Jay-Z, and some of these top musicians, Michael Jackson, once they release any musical album, what they do is that they take the musical album to their temple and they invoke a demon called Medes. And they summon about eight witches, and they will invoke demons and dedicate the CD to Satan himself. So I'm talking about the master. Any number of copies is duplicated into the demons monitor these things, and they use them for mind control. I've done a lot of research on music and how Satan uses it to control the minds of people. So what do you expose yourself to? Whatsoever thing you take into yourself is stored right there in your heart. If you are listening to sexy music, you're listening to music that are violence, music that promotes drugs, songs that promote immorality, you are polluting your heart. If you are a Christian, stay away from things that will defile you. Me, I've put a lot of restraint on myself. I rarely watch TV because our mainstream media have been polluted. It's difficult for you to, even when you listen to news, when they want to slot in their adverts, you see almost all the adverts today are sexually tense and sexually polluted. So the battle to actually live a pure life, pure Christian life, is getting more and more difficult. If you live well, you could just screen so many things, so many struggles out of your life. We are in the world, but not of this world. So if you are living in this world, there are things that you must not expose yourself to. Stay away from people who give dirty jokes, people who say dirty things, because even you may not pay attention to them the moment you hear them, but when you are in your quiet place, then these things could just pop up. You could just be in church, and when the worship leader is saying, lift up your hands, focus on heaven, the Lord is going to touch you now, you could just see those bad things popping up in your heart. Satan uses them against you because he knows that if he has control over your heart, he is going to definitely control the totality of your life. So be careful how you hear, be careful the kind of music you listen to. When I bought public public transport, if I'm close to the driver, if they are playing some kind of music, I try in a very friendly but persuasive way, tell them to either lower it down or change the music, because I shouldn't imprison myself the fact that I have no car and I'm in your car traveling somewhere. You should not, it's not, I have my own right. I have the right to choose what I listen to. But if I can't change it at all, I try to persuade the person to turn the volume down so that I go with my earpiece, listen to Christian music, listen to preachings, listen to things that will edify me. So whatsoever thing that cannot contribute to your Christian life, please do not listen to it. Be careful how you hear, because whatsoever thing you continue to feed your mind with, that thing has the power to change your mind, has the power to affect the way you think. The Bible says in Joshua chapter 1 verse 8 that we should constantly meditate on the word of God. So by the time you continue to meditate on the word of God, it will change the way you think. The psalmist says, how can a young man keep his way pure? By meditating on the word of God. Your word have I hidden in my heart so that I will not sin against you. If you continue to feed yourself with junks, if you continue to feed your minds with things that can pollute you, it will definitely lead you into sin. So feed yourself, get audio Bibles, play this thing. Even when you are sleeping, if you play audio Bibles, if you play Christian music, they affect you. Remember, your mind is not sleeping, your brain is not sleeping. So even when you are sleeping, you can still continue to feed your mind. It is what I do. Me, I do it. I have audio Psalm. I like Psalm. I like Revelation, especially the dramatic one. I play these things a lot. When I sleep, I play them and just lower it so that it will disturb my sleep. And it has a way of improving on your revelational life, your relationship with God. If your house, if your mindset is right with God, and you're meditating on, you're listening to this audio Bible and you sleep off, it's going to affect the atmosphere of your mind, and it helps your relationship with God. I mean, your God communicating with you. Before I round off, I want to tell you that music has so much power. That is why Satan is using it. God loves music. Remember, when Saul sinned against God and the Spirit of God left Saul, it was suggested to him that he should get someone that is a harpist, somebody skilled in music. So David was selected for that job. And the Bible says that whenever he played, Saul would become normal. But after a time, the spirit would come to torment Saul again. So that is a good music. What about when you play a bad music? You see that music even has the way of driving away evil spirits. So if you are even battling with evil spirits, powers tormenting your mind, maybe suicide thoughts and different kind of thoughts, sexual thoughts, and you are battling, especially those of you who are addicted to sex, to pornography, to masturbation, and different kind of evil things, evil habits that you strongly with. Apply the use of music. Music has so much power, and it will help you, it will help your mind, it will help you to have a lot of control, and the Spirit of God too will take over your atmosphere. When you listen to music, both the right side of your brain and the left side of your brain are activated. Most activities are done just with only one side of the brain functioning, being active, but when it comes to music, both the left and the right are active. So music has a lot of power. Know what you listen to. If you know comedians who say dirty jokes, please stay away from them. In fact, some time ago, the Lord warned me in a revelation that I should not be listening to comedians, because some of these things they say, they are offensive to God. So we should stay away from these things. If you want to, you want your Christian life to be smooth, please stay away from things that can pollute you, things that can drag you backward. Thank you. God bless you for listening. If this message is useful to you, if you find it edifying, please share it, and also subscribe to my YouTube channels. I have 3 main YouTube channels: Hosanna E.E. David, Igwe Ayopona, and BS Purity TV. BS Purity TV, what I do, that I teach godly sexuality, it's a biblical sexual purity. And I have 2 websites, biblicalsexualpurity.com and igwayopener.com. Just subscribe and share my teachings, share videos, and the Lord will bless you. Stay away from sin, even as we wait for the second coming of Jesus Christ. Thank you. Don't forget, evangelize by sharing this video. Bye-bye.